Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This video is part of a course called as CCA Data Analyst in which HiveScoop and Impala are covered quite extensively. If you want to learn any of these technologies or prepare for the certification, you can enroll for our course for $10 by going through the information in description. Also, we provide something called as Big Data Developer Labs. If you want to sign up for the labs and practice, you can actually go to the description and click on the link to get details about the labs. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and also click on notify button so that you get notified whenever we create free content as part of our channel. CCA 159 Data Analyst Certification is based on Scoop and querying interfaces. When it comes to querying interfaces in Cloudera-based distributions, we have two interfaces. One is Hive and Impala. When it comes to the syntax of the queries with respect to Hive and Impala, it is almost same. You don't need to worry too much about the syntactical differences. There are very minute differences, especially while loading data into the Impala tables when we compare to Hive, and I'll be covering those aspects as part of this module. That being said, if you know Hive, you should be able to answer the questions with respect to Impala as well. If there are any questions as part of CCA 159 which refers Impala, don't panic. If you know Hive, you should be able to pick it up very easily. As part of the cluster that we provide to you for your practice, Impala might not be there. However, I'll be highlighting some of the key features which you should be able to understand and also which you should be able to explore while taking the certification exam, and then give the exam based upon the requirement if you are forced to give the solution for a given question as part of the exam using Impala as the querying interface. We will get into those details and you should be able to understand those without any issues. However, if you have a Cloudera cluster already, if you have Impala on it, you should be able to practice and it might give a bit more confidence compared to practicing on our cluster. However, at this time, we might not be able to provide Impala as part of the cluster due to the distribution we are using for our cluster. However, it is not showstopper. You should be able to practice as much as you can with Hive and you should be able to adapt to Impala while taking the exam and then you should be good to go. That being said, the main categories where Impala is referred are these two: provide structure to the data and data analysis. As part of provide structure to the data, they are saying that use data definition language statements to create or alter structures in the metastores for use by Hive and Impala. With respect to data analysis, they are saying use query language statements in Hive and Impala to analyze data on the cluster. When it comes to most of the commands, the syntax is same between Hive and Impala, and also Hive and Impala uses something called as Hive Metastore. If you already have gone through the Hive modules as part of our course, you should know what is Hive Metastore is, and I will again reiterate with respect to Impala, and then you should be able to understand the dependency of Hive Metastore with both Hive as well as Impala, and also you will be able to understand how we can use Impala to submit the same set of queries which we have already explored as part of the Hive.